Babe?
Well, there you are. I finally put your dinner in the refrigerator.
Where'd you been?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Well, that isn't right. Of course I know where I've been. I know. It's just I was tired and pulled over and slept alongside the road, I guess.
Well, I guess I'd rather have you late than crash the car.
It looks good. Did you do all that today?
I don't know. Isn't there too much purple in it?
No, I think it looks good with the yellow. Babe, I'm sorry.
What are you kidding? It feels like I'm carrying a basketball. I'm starting to waddle.
Yeah, he's not only kicking.
He's doing somersaults. I think he's gonna grow up to be a gymnast.
No, he's not home yet. No, nothing.
Well, I don't know. Ever since I found out I was pregnant, he's just not the same. He's miserable. Especially when I talk about the baby. He's been so different. You don't think he could be having an affair, do you?
No.
I don't know. I hope not. Especially now.
Sir,
fucking cutthroats. They don't know what they're dealing with here.
They vetoed the budget?
No, they passed it. But it was like performing dental surgery on a shark. Have you got a full report?
All preparations have been made for the rendezvous. The 47 Majestic and all related materials have been transferred here.
Excellent. Dr. Ritter.
I checked with him this morning. He says they're ready for the exchange.
Good. Contact all departmental heads. Tell them I want a meeting with them tomorrow. 0800 and contact our friends. Let them know everything on our end is all set.
Yes, sir.
What's wrong? You haven't said two words all night.
Nothing, I'm fine.
You don't act fine. What's up?
It's my mother. She called me at work today.
What'd she have to say?
She wants me to go through some of my father's stuff with her.
It's gotta be hard on her.
I don't know. I can do it.
Oh, Kev. Your dad's been dead a year. You've got to deal with it sometime.
I know. It's just that I feel so bad.
Bad? About what?
You really put us through hell, Kim. He tried to apologize, but I wouldn't listen. He always looked so disappointed, like... He really needed to tell me something. You want to talk to somebody, go to an AA meeting, right? That's what that shit's for.
Your dad was an alcoholic most of your life. You can't just turn that kind of resentment off like a switch.
But he hadn't drank in years.
You remember that fishing trip we took in the mountains with your parents? Remember when you and your dad tipped over the canoe in the lake? You were both wearing hip waders, and they filled full of water and you guys couldn't get out.
How could I forget? Dad and I almost drowned in Bradenton Lake.
Maybe you didn't come right out and forgive him. Or even tell him that you loved him. But he knew you did.
You think so?
Without a doubt.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. Kevin, have you ever thought about seeing someone?
Like who?
Like a counselor or something. Someone to talk to.
Kim, I barely feel comfortable talking to you about this, let alone some stranger.
Well, thanks.
No, I didn't mean that.
No, it's okay. I know. I just think it would be a good idea if maybe... I think you should just see someone.
You want me to see a shrink?
A counselor or a psychiatrist. Not a shrink.
No, I don't think so.
Think about it, please. If we're going to have kids of our own, I want them to have the most well-adjusted father in history.
So weird tonight.
What was?
Tonight when I blacked out on the road.
I thought you said you fell asleep.
Well, I did, but I don't remember pulling over anything.
Well, you were probably just so tired you don't remember. You put in a pretty long week.
Yeah, maybe. It just kind of scared me. I used to black out when I was a kid.
You never told me that.
I never thought it was important.
Well, did your parents ever take you to see a doctor or anything?
Yeah, a couple times.
And they never figured out what was wrong?
No.
You're so tiny. How far along are you?
Oh, I'm only 5 months.
What do you name the baby?
Well, if it's a girl, I like the name Ashley.
Mm.
The boy, I'm going to name him Kevin.
Kevin, that's a nice name. Is it your husband's name?
No. I used to have an imaginary friend named Kevin. We play together. If ever I was scared or anything, it'd always make me feel better.
Mm.
Of course, I'll have to talk it over with Tim.
Don't you have to work today?
It's vacation day.
Oh, so you decided to visit your poor old gray-haired mother. Isn't that sweet?
Would you like something to drink?
No, I'm fine.
Uh-oh. What's wrong? You know that look.
Is everything all right between you and Kimmy?
Oh, yeah, everything's fine. Just that she's talking about having kids again.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing if I didn't just buy a house.
Yeah?
I don't know if I can afford it. I don't know if I'm ready.
There's nothing to be afraid of. If you wait till you're ready, you'll never have children. Then where will I be?
Mm-hmm. How you been feeling?
Oh, all right, I guess.
Well, that doesn't sound very convincing.
I've had this headache for the past 2 days, and I've been afraid to take anything for it.
I'll give you something before you leave. Good. Strong. Want to listen? You want to see what we've got here?
Yeah. Oh my God, look at his little hands. He's sucking his thumb.
I suggest blue is the color for the baby's room.
Blue? You mean he's a boy?
Mm-hmm. Unless there are two umbilical cords.
Everything is all right, isn't it, Doctor?
Yes, everything's fine. You've gained just the right amount of weight. The baby's strong. You just continue to eat the right foods.
It's just I get a little nervous sometimes.
No need to. In fact, everything's perfect.
I have the observation report on Pearson. He was picked up last night. Apparently the 74 implant couldn't be reactivated.
Well, keep an eye on him. I want to know if this next one takes.
Oh my God, what are you up to? What's wrong?
Does something have to be wrong for a man to cook dinner for his beloved wife?
I guess not.
We have got fettuccine Alfredo. Chef salad, and for dessert, apple pie. I have a confession to make. I bought the apple pie.
All right. I give up. What's going on?
I've been doing some thinking.
About what?
You're right. I think we should have the child.
Oh my God! Are you serious? What made you change your mind?
I was talking to my mother today, and she told me that if we wait to have this child, we might never have it.
Mm, I've always liked your mother.
So when do we get started?
Well, it's probably going to take a few tries and a lot of practice.
To put forth the extra effort.
Thank you. I love you.
I love you too.
What are you trying to do? Give me a heart attack?
Where were you?
Out.
You're drunk.
You think? Well, I'm just getting started. I thought I told you to go to the store.
You had the car all day.
Well, that's no excuse.
You were with her, weren't you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Tim, I saw you today. Who is she?
None of your business.
None of my business? I'm your wife. What is wrong with you?
Get your filthy hands off me.
I'm trying to understand here. Why are you acting like this? I need you. This baby needs you.
The baby?
Yes, your child.
My child. My child?
Yes.
You lying bitch. How can you say that to me? How can you have the gall to pretend that that baby is mine?
What are you talking about? Of course this baby is yours. I've never been unfaithful to you.
You make me sick.
Why? I love you. What makes you think I slept around on you?
Because, dear wife, I'm sterile. I had the mumps when I was 20, and they told me I could never father a child.
Well, they're wrong. I'm pregnant with your baby.
Don't give me that shit. I don't know whose it is, but it's not mine.
Everything you told me to. Why did I lose my baby?
You didn't do anything wrong. You had a miscarriage. It wasn't your fault. Where's Tim?
He's been here to see you, hasn't he?
No, and I don't think he'll be coming. We split up last night.
Well, maybe some things were said last night, but I'm sure once he finds out what's happened, he'll come. I'll call him at the office.
No, I don't think he will. It's just as well he... But I woke up and called the ambulance.
Dr. Blair. All right, well, you get some rest, okay?
I'm afraid to go to sleep.
Well, you try anyway.
I've seen this thing 1,000 times, and every time I see it, I'm amazed by its design, its awesome power, what it represents.
Department heads are ready for you, sir.
Good.
Okay, people. Time is short. We only have 2 weeks until the rendezvous. Dr. Ritter?
We moved all the patients here to the base's infirmary. I'm keeping them sedated.
Keep them that way until our friends arrive. I've got enough to worry about. Kutelski.
No one is allowed in without full Andromeda clearance and retinal scans. This complex is 200 feet below ground. Nobody gets in without an invitation. Or out, for that matter.
Good. Dr. McCleary?
Yes.
The Majestic.
My team has run into a few problems.
What problems?
We haven't been able to reestablish power to the Majestic.
But you said that wouldn't be a problem.
It won't be. We just need a little more time.
There isn't any more time. Your people have had 50 years to put it back together.
Sir, we don't understand how their fusion reactor works if we continue to...
Now you listen to me. The reactor is the key to this whole thing. Without it, there will not be a rendezvous. This is only the fifth time we've met them since the whole thing started in 47. Know what's happened every time. Large jumps in technology, computers, stealth technology, the entire space program. This time, cold fusion. Now we've learned everything we can from taking this bird apart. We need to talk with their engineers. We need their resources. We need that reactor in operation. Now they've made it clear they don't have the time to fix all of our broken toys. I want you to get that thing back together, and I want it operational before the rendezvous. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
I went to see a doctor today.
A doctor? Why? What's wrong?
Nothing, I'm fine. It's just that... I need to tell you something. I don't want to have children ever.
Wait, yesterday you said you wanted to start a family.
I know what I said, Kim. I changed my mind. I had a vasectomy today.
You bastard! How could you just stop even talking to me first? I don't understand you. You know how bad I wanted to have a baby. How could you play with my feelings like this?
I'm not playing with your feelings, Kim.
Oh, what do you call it then?
Kim, just trust me. I don't know why, but I know that we should not have children.
No, I don't trust you. I don't even know you anymore.
Kim, listen to me. I had to do it.
Oh, bullshit. I've always been there for you, and all you've done is lie to me and make promises you don't intend to keep. You must really hate me to want to hurt me this much.
Kim, that's not true. I love you.
Well, you've got a funny way of showing it, Kevin.
What are you doing?
Packing. I'm leaving you.
No, Kim, don't leave. You can't go. I'm sorry. Do you want me to say I'm sorry? I'm sorry, okay? Please, Kim, stay.
Why should I stay with you? When we got married, you said we could start a family after we got settled. Then it was after we got the house. Now you have a vasectomy? I want to know why. Why did you do this?
I don't know why. I woke up this morning and I just knew I can't allow myself to father a child. It wouldn't be fair to it.
That's it? That's all you have to say to explain yourself?
I know it sounds crazy, but that's all I can say.
And all I have to say is our marriage is over. I don't want to live with anyone who can be that selfish.
Where are you gonna go?
Does it matter?
Yes, it matters.
Not to you, it doesn't. Not anymore.
Kim, wait.
What?
I love you.
You should have thought of that this afternoon.
Girl, and I can't get her out of my head. Get back in the house! Get back in the house! And I see Dad. What is this? What is this?
It's nothing.
It's
lightning
not nothing.
Hit there and it caused a brush fire. Nothing
lightning did not strike that.
Again.
Lightning did not cause that, Mom.
It did.
Let me see your arm.
What?
What is this?
Nothing. It's just a scar.
It's not a scar. I've got a scar just like it, Mom, in the same spot.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about this. I'm talking about that. And I'm talking about what happened here 20 years
no.
ago. I remember, Mom. I've seen them. I saw them.
You're crazy.
I was about 7 or 8. And there was a thing in the field
lightning
right here
hit
in this
spot. That's all.
And I saw this little girl with them.
I'm not listening to any more of this.
Remember. You remember, don't you?
Kimberly was right to leave you. You've lost your mind.
God damn it, Mom. You remember.
No.
I know you do.
No. Yes. I remember. How could I forget the things that they've done to me? How could I forget them taking a child right from my womb?
They took a baby from you?
For years I thought I was crazy. They haunted me the whole time I was growing up. I didn't think they were real. Not until they took my baby. I hated them for using me to create them. I never saw your brother again. But no matter how hard they tried, I never forgot again. I remember it all now. I'm not sure that I hate them. If I do, it's for taking him away from me. And for what they did to you.
How come you never told me any of this?
How could I tell you? How could I tell anybody? They'd think I was crazy. I thought I was crazy. And then, as you were growing up, they stopped bothering us. I thought it was all over. But it's not over, is it?
Hatch me into Mr. Katowski. Yes, sir. We seem to have a bit of a problem here.
You can see it right there in the frontal lobe.
What is it, a tumor?
Well, that would be consistent with the seizures and delusions. It doesn't seem to be organic, though.
Well, what do you mean? Is it a tumor or isn't it?
Well, if I went just by this scan, I would say no. It doesn't appear to be living tissue. It looks like some sort of debris that's lodged itself into the brain. Well, regardless of where it came from, I recommend we take it out.
Open brain surgery?
No, I don't think we need to be that invasive, though. We can go in right through the nasal cavity into the frontal lobe.
Nurse, hand me a probe, please.
No more.
Blood pressure's 120 over 80.
I've got it localized.
Blood pressure's at 90 over 65.
What is it? Look at that. It's covered in some sort of organic tissue.
It doesn't look like brain tissue.
Get that thing to the lab right away.
Doctor.
It's dissolving.
I want this room clean, not an ounce of evidence.
Hey! What are you doing?
Who are you? You're interrupting a surgical procedure.
Yes, I am, Doctor. This operation is over. Mrs. Bradford is no longer a patient of yours. Doctor?
She can be gone.
She's not going anywhere.
I'm calling security.
Jesus! I think you'll find security leans more to my point of view, Doctor. Interrogate the hospital staff. I want to know if they've seen anything out of the ordinary. Doctor, either you sign a certificate logging the time of death for Mrs. Bradford, or someone's going to be signing one for you.
Kevin?
Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice. Come on in.
So, what you're telling me that apart from coming from an alcoholic home and being periodically abducted by aliens since you were a child, you're a well-adjusted, normal guy. Am I right?
Excuse me?
You said you recently split up with your wife.
No. This is not about my wife, and do not condescend to me.
Look. I'm not trying to insult you, but as a psychologist, I have to look into the possibility that you might be
crazy.
Well, I was going to say delusional, but crazy works.
Where the hell do you get off? Look, I didn't come here to be psychoanalyzed by you.
Why are you here, Mr. Pearson?
Because I thought you could help me. Because I thought you would believe me. Look, I've got scars on my body that I know these things inflicted on me. My mother... I had a vasectomy because of these things. Doesn't that say something?
So let's explore this possibility. You're 28 years old. Your wife's pressuring you to have children. But if you have children, you're going to have to face the possibility of growing up. And this scares you. So your subconscious creates a fantasy terror world. It creates aliens that steal children from their beds at night. And when it comes to the point of you going out and having a vasectomy, you concoct more stories about aliens to hide your real reasons. Your fear of responsibility. Your wife leaves you. And all of a sudden we create more stories about aliens to help you hide the pain. How does that sound?
Like you're full of shit. Listen, a guy doesn't just wake up one day and go, I don't want to grow up, so I think I'll have the dog fixed. And then maybe I'll make up stories about aliens just so the wife will understand. Listen, I don't remember everything. But I remember enough. Enough to come here and risk being ridiculed by you. I wanted to stop. They took away my childhood. They ruined my life. How many other lives have they destroyed?
Hello, Henry. How are you feeling?
Who are you?
I'm your doctor.
Where's Dr. O'Sullivan? Where am I?
Dr. O'Sullivan is no longer in charge of your care. You're in a hospital. A psychiatric hospital.
What?
Hold on. Just relax. The tumor you had caused you to hallucinate.
I was not hallucinating. I know what I saw.
Calm down, Amber. Listen to yourself. Monsters stole your child?
I am not delusional. Those things are real. I am not nuts, and I know what I saw.
No one thinks you're nuts. You're under observation.
This is crazy. I'm leaving. Where are my clothes?
You can't leave, Anne-Marie.
Why?
Because you're here for your own protection.
I don't need protecting.
I think you do. From yourself. Try to get some rest and we'll talk later.
Where are you going? Wait! I am allowed visitors, aren't I?
Of course.
Well, I need to contact a friend. Can you call him for me?
I can try. What's his name?
His name is Kevin. Kevin Pearson. He lives in upstate New York, I think.
Are you gonna call him or not?
Hey,
want a full report.
Well, the implant that we installed isn't working.
Obviously. What I want to know is why it isn't working.
I don't know. Perhaps the trauma of removing the fetus is so strong with her that it refuses to be repressed.
What about the rest of her memories? How much does she know?
They seem to be resurfacing as well. You heard her mention Pearson. I think it's just a matter of time before it all comes back to her.
Well, it really doesn't matter now. She's dead as far as the world's concerned anyway. When she's fully recovered from her surgery, I want her drugged and given to our friends. Got it?
Yes, sir.
All right, Kevin. You're a time traveler. You have the ability to move back and forward in time as you wish. Do you understand? Now I want you to go back in time. I want you to go back in time to the first time that you saw them. Tell me, how old are you, Kevin?
Listen to me, Kevin. I'm going to count backwards from five now. I'm going to bring you back. Five. Four. Listen to me, Kevin. Three. Two. One. Are you okay? What do you remember?
Everything.
Okay. Show yourself, little freaks. Come on. Come on, show yourself!
Get him up. Just listen to me, and listen to me clearly. You are screwing around with things that are better left alone. Keep this up, and we'll go after your family next. Some things are better left unexplained, Mr. Pearson.
That's why they call them mysteries.
The girl. I found the girl. Her picture was in the newspaper today. Under her picture, though, was her obituary. It says here she died in childbirth. She lived in Oswego, New York. I've already missed the services, but hopefully I can track down some of her family and ask them some questions.
Look, Kevin, I don't think this is a real good idea right now.
Bullshit! It's a great idea. Now you can either argue with me or you can meet me here. Either way, I'm going.
Columbo.
You had a few hours head start. What'd you find out?
A lot. She was a hairdresser. I talked to one of the girls at the salon she worked with. She told me quite a bit.
Like what?
Well, she had recently split up with her husband. He owned a construction company in town. You know, this might sound strange, but I think I'd know if she was dead.
Did you get a chance to speak to the husband?
Well, I went to his office, but he was out of town. Vacation.
Huh. Seems really broken up about it, huh?
That was my opinion.
Any other family?
The girl at the salon told me that both her parents were deceased. She didn't know any other relatives, but she did tell me who the family doctor was and what hospital she was at.
What the hell is this?
You sure you got the right address?
We have a DOA, white male, 60 years of age, height 5'7", weight 205 pounds, uniforms and EMTs are on site, coroner is en route. And yeah, Bates, just let the detectives that are en route know that it appears to be accidental head trauma at this time. There does not appear to be foul play.
Kevin, I don't think he's going to be able to answer any of your questions.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Dr. Donaldson.
He just got a surgery a little while ago. I think he left for the day, though.
Oh.
No, hey, he's still here.
Excuse me, Dr. Donaldson. Excuse me, I wonder if I could ask you a few questions. Hey! Thank you.
give me one good reason why you just assaulted that man?
What more do you people want from me? I haven't said anything, I swear.
What are you talking about? We just wanted to ask a few questions. Why'd you have to go off running for?
What is this, a joke? Of course I ran. I know who you are, and I know what you're trying to do. And if you threaten me or my family, I'm going to tell the whole world. I swear.
What?
I've kept my end of the bargain. I haven't said anything. What more do you people want from
me? Said anything about what?
Look, if you're going to kill me, just do it and get it over with.
What are you talking about?
I've been living in fear since the day you people broke into my operating room.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about? God damn it, answer me!
Kevin! For Christ's sake, Kevin, let him go!
You people aren't really with them, are you?
What are you talking about? We just wanted to ask you a few questions about a friend of mine. She was a patient of yours on Dr. O'Sullivan's.
Jim was a friend of mine, and now he's dead. And they're probably going to kill me, too.
Who? Who's going to kill you?
Government men, I think.
Men in black?
Why? Why? Why would they want to kill you?
Because of what we found.
What did you find?
Oh, what the hell? They're going to kill me anyway. About a week ago, Jim came to me with a patient of his. A girl was having seizures, so we took a CAT scan, and just as I suspected, the scan showed a brain tumor.
What was her name?
Anne Marie something. I forget. We decided to operate, and sure enough, we found a brain tumor, but when I extracted it, it wasn't organic.
Well, what was it?
I don't know. It was some sort of metallic pellet. As soon as I removed it, it disintegrated.
Disintegrated?
Right before my eyes. Just disappeared. And then they came in. In 2.5 minutes, they turned my operating room upside down. Started harassing my staff, asking us questions, and threatening us if we told anything we'd seen. That was 4 days ago. There were 4 people in that operating room, and since then, my nurse has been killed in an auto accident. I can't find my anesthetist. And now Jim is dead, and it doesn't take a brain surgeon to figure out that I'm probably next.
What about the girl? How'd she die?
Die? She didn't die. They took her.
I think you're starting to hear things.
I'm telling you, I heard something.
Well, there's nothing there.
What's the difference anyway? It's only a matter of time before they come and get us. God, I feel awful. 5 years I've been sober, and these assholes have to go and mess it all up.
What are we going to do?
Whatever we do has to be well thought out.
We've got to go to the press.
With what? We don't have any real proof.
We've got to tell someone.
So what are we going to tell them? Mysterious government types kidnap a 24-year-old woman, and aliens may have told them to do it. The girl is considered legally dead. Nobody will listen.
If we have the body exhumed, we can prove she isn't dead.
And what if she is in that grave? Maybe they did kill her. Where does that leave us? We still have no proof.
Fine. Fine, you want proof? I'll get you proof.
Definitely got one.
What does it do?
Nobody actually knows what it does. Might be some sort of a tracking device like the ones they use to track wild animals. Or something worse.
I want out.
You don't know what we're dealing with
no,
here.
No, you don't know what we're dealing with here. I've seen these creatures firsthand and I want it out. Can you take it out?
Yeah, I could.
I don't know what's worse, letting them just kill me or being fired for breaking every hospital regulation ever written. I'm going to have to put you out for this.
Whatever. Just get the damn thing out.
You know, you don't have to do this now.
Yes, I do.
I've almost got it. I've got it. It's not disintegrating. All right, I'm done. Come on, help me get him up.
Get him up? He just had surgery.
He'll be fine. Come on, we can't stay here. Help me.
Did you get it out?
We did one better. We got it out in one piece.
Where is it? I want to see it.
Take it easy. You need some rest.
Where are we?
We're in the hotel for the night.
We can't stay here. We got to get out of here. Yeah. Okay. Okay, you win.
I got a friend who runs a lab east of here. We'll take the implant to him. If anybody can figure out what that thing is, he can. Now, why don't you get some rest?
Okay. Okay.
So how are you feeling?
Oh, like I got a mariachi band playing in my head. Other than that, I feel terrible.
Jeez, if I were you, I'd feel pretty good right now.
Yeah? Why?
You're about to get a few of the answers you've been looking for.
Do you really think your friend can help us?
I'm sure of it.
Wow. That is incredible.
You know, I used to sit on my grandmother's porch with her for hours, just stare at the stars. I used to sit and wonder what it must be like out there, what they might be like. Sometimes I wish I didn't know.
Would you two hurry up? I don't like being out here.
Are you sure this is the right place?
Good evening, gentlemen. Find the place okay?
Dr. Donaldson, so good to see you. You don't look like you're feeling too well. I'll bet you could use a drink, couldn't you?
I did what you told me. I kept my mouth shut.
Doesn't look that way to me.
Why don't you give it to him for?
What's the difference? I either give it to him now or they take it off my dead body.
Definitely defective. Maybe they should get the Japanese to make their electronic equipment for them. How are you doing, Kevin? You know, what you did was extremely dangerous and quite stupid. You could have been killed having your drunken doctor friend here remove this thing.
You sound as if you care.
Of course I care. You've been a valued member of this team for years. And your family was instrumental in this project. We needed you. At least we did. But you had a vasectomy. Wasn't a very bright idea. Now, I warned you about this before, but you didn't listen.
Who are you people? I have a right to know.
Don't have any rights. Not about this, not where this is concerned.
I have a right to know what you people did to me.
I have been with you for a long time, Kevin. Think of me as your guardian angel, with you every step of the way. I was there at your graduation, at your wedding. I was even there when you lost your virginity. Let's see, it was in the back of that 77 Chevy you used to have. Now, what was her name? Dawn. Dawn something.
Hubbard.
Hubbard. Dawn Hubbard. That's right. Oh, very pretty girl.
I thought so.
Yes. Well, she was a little bit more experienced than you, but after a while you seemed to get the hang of it.
So what now? Feels like you know Sullivan.
I don't want to kill you, Kevin. I really don't. But your group here is threatening the security of this project and this nation. I'm not going to kill you, Kevin. At least not now. They want you alive for some reason, and I always try to give them what they want.
Congratulations, Mr. Pearson. You're just in time for the big show.
Oh, my God.
Why are you going to think you didn't exist?
It's really you. What are we going to do?
I don't know. I don't know. I caught her in the infirmary.
The infirmary?
She saw the package.
Is our security so lax that a drugged, unarmed girl can wander around this compound unhindered?
Hey!
Kevin!
Hey, where are you taking her?
What is this place?
Dreamland.
Dimensional jump. Fine, sir.
Good.
Very big, Kevin. This is bigger than the both of us, even your friend Anne Marie. They're coming for you, for both of you.
What do they want from us?
They were dying. Their race was unable to reproduce. They spent years searching the galaxy, looking for some genetic code compatible with our own to reproduce offspring.
Humans.
They found us. In 1947, we found them. When they crashed an observation craft, we made contact.
You've been working with them ever since.
Now we have an agreement. We give them the genetic code they need, and they give us the technology we need.
And what about the people they experiment on?
That's an acceptable compromise.
For you.
Everything you've requested is ready. Take him to his holding cell.
You've got a visitor.
Let me ask you a question, Jefferson. How do you sleep at night?
I sleep fine knowing they're on our side.
Are you sure?
I'll leave you two alone. I'm sure you got a lot to talk about.
What are you staring at?
I've come to talk with you.
Get out of my head! Get out of my head! If you want to talk to me, talk to me, but you get out of my head!
Why are you so angry? Why do you care? My people have decided you're no longer needed.
Really?
Ending your ability to reproduce has made you unusable.
Is that why you're here? To give them permission to put a bullet through my brain?
I have come here to give you a choice. At my request, no harm has come to you from your government. After our departure, that will change. If you wish to preserve your life, you may come with us.
That wouldn't be my first choice.
There will be other humans coming with us. That is part of the reason for this, our arrival. Your government feels that certain members of the experiment have been compromised, and to allow them to remain on your world would endanger the project.
What do you care about what happens to me?
You don't remember me, do you?
I remember you. When they took the girl's baby, you were there. You're one of those crossbreeds, aren't you? Who are you?
You and I are the same. We share the same mother.
The same?
You... Does this upset you?
No more than any of this.
This must be very difficult for you. I'm sorry things are the way they must be.
Sorry? You should be sorry. What you're doing is wrong.
Is it wrong to try to preserve our lives?
If it's at the expense of others, yes.
I need your answer. Will you come with us?
No. I want my life back. I want what you people took from me.
If you stay, you will die.
Then I die.
I guess you better go and let these men do their jobs.
Turn around. Place your hands on the wall.
What's the matter? You can't look at me and do it?
I can if I have to. Make it easier on yourself. Turn around. Hold still. I promise you won't feel a thing. Shit. Thank you. Hold it. Don't worry, I'm not gonna hurt you. Just give me the gun.
In my ass ever since I met you. Now, hands on your head. I'm going to walk slowly and quietly down the hall. We need some privacy.
I understand completely. I'm sorry my nightmare's been an inconvenience for you, Doctor. So what happens after I'm dead? Do I just disappear? Does my body show up? What?
I don't care what they do with you. As long as I'm done with you.
I have a right to know.
Thank you.
Director Katowski? They seem to be between floors.
Anymore.
Yeah, I wouldn't be so sure. They had to get that ship in here somehow.
Look, it's outside. We made it.
Wait, Amory, we're still on base. You go first.
I should take this just in case something happens.
It's an implant. Did you get this?
It's not important. Just take it to somebody, the press or something. I don't know.
Okay.
Go! 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 Go!